fellow caregivers, vaccines are the most important public health measure we have to end the COVID-19 pandemic. By following public health guidelines, we're developing plans to distribute vaccines to caregivers in a safe, equitable, and efficient manner. Receiving the vaccine will be a personal choice and not a mandate. Today, I'm joined by clinical leaders who will share information about vaccine science and our caregiver vaccination program in Ohio. We have Dr. Steve Gordon, who is the chair of infectious disease, Dr. Paul Terpolak, chair of occupational health, and Dr. Michelle Medina, associate chief of clinical operations. Thank you all for being with us today. Let's start with you, Steve. Can you please tell us how the COVID-19 vaccines work, and what do we know about their safety and efficacy?
Of the 200 COVID-19 vaccine candidates, it is likely that the messenger RNA vaccines produced by Pfizer and Moderna will be the first to be distributed in the homeland. And each will take a piece of the virus genetic code called the messenger RNA. This provides instructions to code what we call a coronavirus spike protein. And after immunization, the vaccine enters the cell and it instructs the cell to produce the spike protein. And the spike protein then elicits an immune response, which consists of antibodies and T cells, which then helps fight the virus when exposed. We should point out both of these platforms require two immunizations, 21 to 28 days apart. And the vaccine efficacy, which is a measurement of protection against COVID-19 in the trials, was a remarkable 95%. And this contrasts to maybe 40 to 60% for a seasonal influenza. And also importantly, Dom, is that across age, weight, and race, there was no difference in the vaccine efficacy.
But Steve, there is also a conversation about the speed at which these vaccines were developed, as well as the conversation about some of the reported side effects. Can you address these concerns?
This has been a global collaborative to make widely available safe and effective vaccines across the world so we can end this pandemic. And when we look at FDA data submission, say for the Pfizer product, which involved thousands of patients, it's just a very favorable safety profile, and there was no specific identified safety concerns. Having said that, the most commonly reported adverse effects do relate to immunization site in the arm. These are intramuscular injections, pain and swelling. And then there has been some persistent, what we say, malaise, fever, or headache that can also occur. Because of this, we will stagger immunizations in individuals amongst our healthcare teams. And I should also point out, there is a mandatory 15-minute observation period for all recipients to protect against the rare possible immediate hypersensitivity reaction.
Thank you very much, Steve. Paul, what do we know about the early vaccine supply and how are we ensuring an equitable distribution to our caregivers?
It is important to recognize here in the United States, there are four vaccines in FDA clinical trials. Pfizer vaccine is the first to apply to the FDA for the emergency use authorization. With approval granted, Pfizer will ship the vaccine to Ohio. And since Cleveland Clinic is a pre-positioned site in Ohio, we should receive our first allotment soon. Unfortunately, it appears that the first allotment will be limited to about 1,000 doses. Because of this limited supply, we have taken our guidance for who to vaccinate first from both the federal and state governments, where they have built a distribution system based on vaccine availability. The good news is our caregivers are first in line according to this guidance. In order to have a fair and equitable distribution of this first limited allotment, we have identified those caregivers in Northeast Ohio who are essential to maintain our current operations. This includes our COVID ICUs, EDs, and our COVID units. This is a voluntary vaccination program, and those caregivers identified within those units will be invited to schedule an appointment via my chart. So look out for those invitations.
When can we expect that all Cleveland Clinic caregivers will have the opportunity to be vaccinated in your estimate?
Well, I would say soon. Having this vaccine available in such a short time is truly amazing. Remember, we did our first COVID test for the virus just 9 months ago. Because the vaccine production is a manufacturing process where millions of doses are being made, it will be slow in the beginning, but rapidly accelerate. It will take time, but rest assured, every caregiver who wants a vaccine will be given the opportunity to get it. I ask for your patience as this process unfolds. In the meantime, remember, vaccination is only one of many layers of protection against this virus. Continue to utilize all of our layers, including the COVID pass, UPP, hand hygiene, social distancing. and calling our COVID hotline when feeling unwell.
Thank you, Paul. Michelle, once a caregiver is eligible for vaccination, what is the process for vaccination?
Caregivers will receive a MyChart invitation to schedule their first and second dose appointments in one of the vaccination sites. They will need to complete their Ready Set questionnaire prior to arriving at their appointment, similar to how we do it now for employee flu vaccines. As each vaccine location opens, they will see those options become available for scheduling on MyChart.
Caregivers, however, who have had a COVID-19 treatment with either monoclonal antibodies or convalescent plasma in the last 90 days, or currently have active COVID-19 infection, should wait to be vaccinated. If they've had a COVID infection in the last 90 days, they may choose to defer the vaccine because reinfection is uncommon in those first 90 days. Now, if they are pregnant, breastfeeding, or immune compromised, they should discuss having the vaccine with their provider before scheduling it.
Now, Michelle, the frequently asked question from our neighbors, friends from the community, is about when will patients and community members in general be able to receive the vaccine?
Similar to a phased approach with healthcare workers, the first members of the public who will be allocated vaccine are essential workers, seniors, and those with chronic medical conditions who may get severe COVID or die from it. The distribution process for this next group is also being determined at the federal and state level. Beyond that, as more vaccines are produced, we can expect that it will become available to the general public. An early estimate from the CDC, now a lot of this depends on vaccines becoming approved and produced, does show that publicly available vaccine may be here in late spring or summer of 2021.
Now, going back to Steve, a frequently asked question relates to the immunity to COVID-19 following a vaccination. Is a person who's vaccinated immune, and how long will that immunity last?
We do not know the durability of the response to the vaccinations because at this point we only have that 2-month follow-up data past that second immunization, but that will be studied. In addition, as you know, we still don't have a good blood test to provide us correlation of protection whether you get natural COVID or from a vaccine. And the third thing is we still don't know whether receiving the vaccine has influences transmission dynamics. We know it protects against disease, but it still may allow people to transmit asymptomatically. And for those reasons, we are still recommending our healthcare providers who successfully receive vaccination to still distance, mask, and hand hygiene.
I would like to thank you all for joining us today. This is a challenging effort, but one that is critical to the health and safety of our caregivers, patients, and communities. Thank you for everything you are doing to ensure its success.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Vaccines offer great hope of a future without COVID-19. Scientific data around these vaccines' efficacy is absolutely remarkable. The vaccine distribution process will be, without any doubt, a complex undertaking. We will continue to provide transparent information throughout this effort. Thank you for your perseverance.